Today I'll be doing a quick start tutorial for those of you beginner out there who just downloaded the FL Studio mobile app. And by the end of this video, you'll be able to produce a song that sounds like this. Okay, when you're first greeted by the app, you will see something like this. Go into settings and enable ghost notes and also display names. Just follow along and I'll explain along the way. Going out of the settings tab, you would see something called the BPM. From here, you can adjust the beats per minute of the song by pressing the plus or minus sign on the left and right. Or you can manually tune the BPM by moving this circular slider here. You can also even tap your beats and then you will record down your BPM according to how fast you tap it or how slow you tap it. So beats per minute stands for that's how many beats in 1 minute. Songs like Adele's Someone Like You has a BPM of 67, which is quite slow. And progressive house music like Everybody Put Your Hands Up, pom, 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 pom. Those has usually 128 BPM per minute. So today we're going to do something like that as well. We're going to go to 128 BPM per minute. We're going to set it. On top here is the metronome, which we can just turn it on. And the bottom part, time division 4/4. What is that? Aside from beats per minute, the song is further segmented into bars and also phrases. Four beats will make up one bar. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. Four beats making one bar, and four of this bar will make into one phrase, which is separated by this thicker line. Now, why is this important is because normally a song is organized by sections of four bars or one phrase. So for example, the introduction of a song will usually take up four phrases, which is called the breakdown. It's usually very slow, melodic, and the build up will usually take up around two phrases, which is in total 8 bars. And last but not least, the drop, I would say usually would take up another 2 more phrases. So you can actually differentiate the start and stop of the portion of the song by its phrases. So today we'll create a drop which will take up exactly 1 phrase or 4 bars. Okay, let's start by pressing new and select Disco House Template. This whole thing is called the playlist, and each of this is actually a track. For easier understanding, you can think of them each as an instrument. This one is the master track and separated by the other instruments. You can control individual instruments, turning them on and off here. You can even make them play solo. You can adjust whether they come out more towards the left speaker or the right speaker by controlling this small slider here. And the big slider on the right controls the volume of that specific instrument. Now, you may think like we have drum, pick, bass, lead, and bottom there we have strings. So what are these? You can think of them as an analogy of in a band. In a band, you have a lead singer, which normally sings the song, let's say Seven Nation Army. I'm gonna fight them all is the lead. And then we have the drums. That will be the drums right here. And then if you remember at the start of the song, we have a very low frequency melody. That is the bass. And sometimes in the song, you have some backup singers. In this FL Studio template, we'll call them as strings. So why do we have all of this musical instrument playing together? Because they occupy different levels of frequency. Lead will occupy the high side of the frequency. The strings or chords, the backup singer will control the middle range frequency, and the bass will control the lower side of the frequency. So when you combine all of them together, you will have a very full sound. Okay, before we start, you can control the play head by pressing here. Or if you want to stop, just tap on the top bar. And let's start making music with the lead first. So tap on the track and press plus clip. We're going to drag it out until we have a phrase which is 4 bars. You can go into the piano roll by tapping it and press edit, or you can just double tap it. Right now we can draw the song and create a melody, which reminds me, let's turn off the metronome. So a lot of you out there probably don't know how to make a nice melody. One simple tip is to always start with a note that you really enjoy listening to. So I'm just gonna play all the white notes. Okay, I really enjoy this D6. So once you have a note that you really enjoy listening to, think about how that one note, dun, 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 how that one note can be translated into a melody. So probably something like this. And then you just continue. Ding, 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 ding. So that is like a repeating note. Ding, 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 ding. In order to copy paste inside FL Studio, all you have to do is just tap and hold and select all of your notes that you want to copy. Press on copy and then go to the section that you want to paste it. Paste it and then move it to the desired location and done. Yep, we have something there. So I'm going to continue the same process until we have a melody that occupies 4 bars or 1 phrase. 10 minutes later. So I managed to create a melody that sounds like this. So it's actually the same for the first 2 bars. I just copy paste it over, just that the end has a different kind of ending, just to signal the end of that phrase. So sometimes not only just the notes that can inspire you, I was also inspired by the riff of between like G and F, these 2 notes. Then I was playing around A and F. That's how I came up with this section here. Now we have the lead done, let's go into the strings. We're gonna reduce the lead and then we're gonna tap and add clip as usual. Drag it into 4 bars, double tap to go in. And because earlier we had the ghost note turned on, it actually allows us to see the notes from the lead in our piano roll for the strings. So we're gonna use it to guide us to make the melody for the strings. Now the strings, think of it as a backup singer, like there'll be a lot of sound playing in harmony together. Try to make it complementing the lead's melody. So if I play the lead, so it's gonna sound ding 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 ding. So we're gonna find that chord. And because the note actually went up like ding ding ding, so I'm gonna change the chord to go up as well. So maybe something like this. Do note that I'm only playing on the white notes and not the black notes. This is called a C major scale, where a number of notes play together to produce a harmonious sound. If you go out of this scale, the sound wouldn't sound very harmonious. So for simplicity's sake, C major scale is the only scale with all white notes. So therefore, I'm choosing it for this tutorial. And continuing to create the chords, you end up with something like this. So if you notice, it sounds a little bit too high frequency. This is just to guide us so that the chords sound complementary to the lead melody. You can select all of them right now. This note is just below C6. I'm gonna bring it all the way down to C5, lower. And it should sound more complementary to each other, since right now the chords or the string is occupying the middle frequency range. Of course, the chords or the strings is a little bit too loud, so we're going to reduce the volume a little bit to our liking. Yep, that sounds good. Now the fun part is adding drums. So again, we're just going to add in a plus clip here, drag it all the way into one phrase, and then double tap inside. Now you notice that it's a little bit different than other instruments because this drum kit actually allows us to use many type of instruments here. There's kick, snare, percussion, snare, hi-hat, another type of snare, and tom. And we can add kick patterns just by tapping on them. There's no notes here. So right now, if you have a very good lead melody, it should sound very good. Okay, I think the lead is a little bit too loud, so I'm gonna reduce the volume a little bit here. So this is a normal kind of pattern where we have kicks on every bar. I'm gonna add snare on every second and fourth bar, which is coincidentally is painted in a more lighter gray. So it sounds like that. And if you want to layer your snare, you can add in other snare as well. So I'm gonna add this MA Obscura snare, mixing it sound like this. And just to spice things up, I'm gonna add a percussion on the fourth bar, the end here. And then I'm gonna add a chick, yeah, just like that. Now you can control each of this instrument. If you think they're a little bit soft, you can drag the mixer volume as well. So I'm gonna drag it so that. Okay, sounds good. So right now we have the drums, the lead, and also the string. And last but not least, the bass. Add clip, drag. So same like the strings earlier on, we're gonna use the ghost notes to guide us. But think of bass like a very simple riff, like dum 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 dum. Just very simple, single note. There's not a lot of people singing like the strings. So we're gonna add that. Okay, because I cannot hear right now, so I think I'm gonna solo the lead and also the bass and bring down the lead a little bit so that I can hear the bass. So a very simple melody for the bass, but you occupy a lower frequency of the whole song. So I can show you, if I don't have the bass and also the strings, it will sound quite flat. Like a very quiet kind of sound. If I add it, it will sound way fuller. Like a complete song. One more way that you can control the playhead is by tapping the top bar here and then dragging it. So this will confine the play area to a certain section or certain bars. And if you want to cancel it, just tap and hold and you will cancel it. So I just want to play this entire section with an ending to let you hear the complete song. Yup, that is the complete song that we made today. Right now, you should know how to make a song and you have a clear understanding of whether music production, is it for you or not? Do you like it? Do you enjoy the whole music making process? So I've been making music for a while now. So if you want to check out all of my FL Studio music tutorial, the playlist is right here. And if your mom is asking you to go study la boy, then you don't have time to watch videos. You can check out a video recommended by YouTube right here. Until then guys, I'll see you in the next video. Bye. Quick note guys, I actually wrote my melodies in my notebook here and it took me around 2 hours to write it all.